Hey guys, in this video we're going to cover how to use the automation and finally how to export an audio file in Traction 7. Before checking out this video, make sure to watch the rest of the series since this is the last tutorial on Traction 7. Automation is a feature that's found in a lot of digital audio workstations and Traction 7 is no different. This allows you to automate certain mixing controls like volume, panning, and plugins. That way the changes are made automatically each time the track plays, and all those settings can be exported with the project. To add automation, click and drag the A button at the top right of the track to whatever control you want to automate. For example, when you drag it to the volume and pan control for that track, a dropdown will open and allow you to select what you want to control. You can also drag and drop it onto a plugin, and a dropdown will open that will let you choose what plugin control to automate. Once that's done, it will create an automation lane for that track. To add a new node to the lane, double-click and it will create a small square. Then add a second square. Having a difference between the squares will allow for an automated transition between the settings. The circle in the middle of the transition can be dragged to change the curvature. It can be a linear change, curve, or an abrupt change at either end. If you click on a square and press the delete key, it will be removed. If you select the line and press the delete key, it will reset the entire automation lane. If you want a more detailed view of the automation, you can click the plus button underneath the A button and select Add Automation Tracks for each active parameter on this track. Once all the automation is complete, the last thing we need to cover for Traction is how to export the track. This is the last step in any project. To export, click the Export menu in the bottom left panel, then select Render to File. Now we have a few settings to choose. I'll usually create a WAV file to keep it at a high quality. I'll also export at 16-bit and 44,100Hz, even though the project might be higher quality, but just make sure to keep dithering enabled. In addition to the WAV file, it's also helpful to create an MP3. This compressed file is slightly lower quality, but it also takes up less space, so it's easier to share online. To do this, you'll also need to download and install LAME Encoder, then just export your file at whatever quality settings you prefer. Thanks for checking out this video on how to use automation and export your projects in Traction 7. If you found this video and this series helpful, don't forget to give it a like, subscribe to the channel, and press the bell icon to get notifications whenever a new video is released. You can also check the video description for links to social media accounts so you can stay up to date on all our new content.